Hi, I'm Jasmine Greenaway, and in this demo, we're going to do some conversions with strings and numbers. Throughout this demo, we're going to be using two variables, num1, which is the number 150 as a string, and flow1, which is a floating point number, and it's 1.50, and also a string. In this example, where we're converting strings to integers, we're using the Parseint function. This is built in to JavaScript, so you don't have to add a library or anything like that. You just use it in the casing that you see here. So lowercase p, uppercase I. So here we're converting the string number 100, then we convert num1 to the number representation of 150. And notice that we try to convert the string ABC, but it's not a number, so JavaScript prints not a number to the console as well. Line 9 is a special case because 0xf does have non-numerical characters in it, but JavaScript treats it like a hexadecimal number. So it prints the number 15, and that is the integer form of this hexadecimal number here. On lines 13 to 15, we're converting some strings to floats. Notice that the casing is very similar to Parseint. So in this first example, we're converting the number 1.00 to a floating point number, and it just prints 1. It drops the zeros after this, and there are ways to format this if you would prefer to preserve these zeros after this 1. In line 14, we are using the variable 1.5 that was a string to convert it to the floating point number 1.5. And again, on line 15, we are trying to convert a string that is not numerical to a number, and it prints not a number. On line 20 and 21, we're just doing some more examples here. Notice that parseInt is trying to convert 1.5. What happens here is that parseInt will ignore any characters and then ignore any numbers that happen to be after any special characters. So the only characters that are allowed in parseInt are numbers or numbers that represent either hexadecimal or octal or things like that. So here it just prints 1. Now say this was 0.5, it would actually print not a number because the first thing it reads is that period character, and that's not a number. On line 21, we're doing a similar example. Here we have 1 plus 1, and you would expect that maybe you would print 2, but remember this 1 plus 1 here is a string. So what it's going to do is it's going to look for any numbers as the first character. What's happening here is that parseInt sees the 1 character here and it converts that to 1, notices that there's a space, and then notices that there's a plus sign after here, which can't be parsed to numbers. So it just ignores everything after the plus sign and actually everything after the space, and then just prints the number 1. Now line 24 is a pretty special case here where it uses temperate literals. And a temperate literal is a string, and the cool thing about it is that you can evaluate expressions inside the temperate literal before you do anything else with it. So here we're evaluating the expression 1 plus 1 with these placeholder characters here, the dollar sign and the curly braces. And then we evaluate that to 2, and then we convert it with parseInt. So at this point, it is a string representation of the number 2, and then parseInt goes and finishes the work of converting it to 2. And that's why it works here. And in this final example, we're converting some numbers to string. And this is pretty straightforward. No matter what number it is, you're just going to use the method toString to convert it to a string. And notice that, again, it is case sensitive. And also keep in mind to add the open and close parentheses here as well.